I'm a super fan of The Expanse, so it goes without saying that I was stupid excited to go to Toronto for 3 days and watch them make the show and some other stuff I can't quite talk about yet, but I did get to sit down with showrunner Naren Shankar. I've known Naren since 2008 when he put Jamie and I in a cameo on CSI, and here's what he had to say about working on The Expanse on, by the way, what was their last day of production of season two.
You're in the cramming for the finals test, yes, right here on The Expanse. This is the last like 6 days of production. Mm-hmm. How many things are you balancing today?
Today, let's see. Getting a cut to network, getting another cut to the studio, approving visual effects, this wrap party, getting another scene that needs to be shot, ready to go. I don't know, there's probably a couple others.
And how many people in total are working on this production right now? This is at this peak.
Everybody? It's probably about like 150 or so. Maybe a little bit more if you count like office, support staff.
How do you possibly manage that number of people towards a single goal? I mean, it's like herding cats, I would imagine.
You know what? Luckily, I don't have to do a lot of it because Everybody here is an amazing professional. And, you know, movie companies and television productions, they're like small startup companies, and where everybody is incredibly good at their job and the department heads are incredible. And so you ask for things and then suddenly there they are. And I think everybody feels like they can look at the show and find parts of themselves in it. When you can give people collective ownership of the creative product, you get the best from people. And at the end of the day, you know, it shows because people work their asses off and accomplish the impossible, and what we ask of them, I'm astonished that it comes through. There are times when I go, just like, God, how did you guys do this? I know we asked you to, but still, when we started this show in, I think development was like April of 2014. That's when the writers started for season one, and Mark Ferguson and Hawk Osby, who wrote the pilot, they had done, you know, they developed that over, I think, the previous almost 2 years beforehand. Mm. So it feels like since April of 2014, I feel like I have just been going continuously, because one season kind of rolls into the other, and we, you know, the visual effects side of things was so elaborate. It took just a long time to finish the shows, and suddenly here we are in season two, and now we're at the end of season two. It's so rare when you can do a science fiction show that feels like it hasn't been done before. Mm-hmm. And this is one of them. It's like, I just think it's a different look, it's different subject material, it's just the kind of thing that nobody gets to see. And you know, I used to be an engineer, and it's like, it's lovely when you can make, or at least try to make, the reality of space and space itself a character in the show. And that's been a big part of it too.
The ships are characters, space is a character, the science of gravity is a character. I mean, as an engineer, that must be thrilling for you to be able to bake that right into the DNA.
It really is. And you know what? And I didn't bake it in. It's Ty and Daniel baked it in into the books. And when you read the books, when I read Mark and Hawk's pilot, it was like, it was clear that was the intention. The show was delving into life in space, a colonized solar system, in a way that I'd never seen it done before. And I've been away from science fiction for a lot of years, mm-hmm, because I hadn't found it, you know, really very interesting, with the exception of Battlestar Galactica, which I thought was a masterpiece. This one just piqued my interest. I was kind of like, wow, this is something I haven't seen before. And the opportunity to be a part of it was like, I was like, I'm in.
You've also built a really impressive cast of not just terrific actors, but of a real incredibly stunning diversity. And that I love The Expanse's vision of the future as a place where everybody is kind of a little bit of everything.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Well, that was in the book. And if you look at the names, everybody's name is like a strange mix of like African, Danish, hyphenated. It's like, it's like all over the place. And I think Ty and Daniel were, because they were part of the writer's room from the mm-hmm very beginning, they were like, we don't want Bobby to be like a tall blonde girl. And we're like, no one has any intention of making her a tall blonde girl. It's like, she's like half Samoan. It's like, that's what we're going to try to find. And so, you know, they were pleasantly surprised by the fact that we really tried to maintain the ethnicity of the cast that was in the books in the show, because it was saying something. And what it was saying is what you were just saying, which mm-hmm is that humanity melted together, that the people who went into space weren't just, you know, Caucasian Americans, it was Russians and Chinese and Indians and Africans and every mix of ethnicity that ended up as a result. We wanted to put that on the screen because that also says something about humanity and the future.
And now we're at the end of season two. We're in the Ganymede tunnels, ice tunnels, and you were just telling me this has been six different sets over last year. And it's about to be torn down and put away.
I know, it's kind of sad. This started as the Ceres Medina, which is where the Belters lived, and then it became Eros Station, which was a different look for it. Then it became Phoebe Science Station, which was Phoebe Moon of Saturn, where the protomolecules discovered. Then it became Ganymede Station. Oh, wait, I left out protomolecule Eros Station, because when the protomolecule takes over Eros, it's like that was part of it too, as another look. And finally it ended up as the ancient ice tunnels in the bottom of Ganymede Station. So they got a lot of use out of them.
Yeah, you've certainly gotten your value. Naren, thank you so much for letting me come play on your set. I really appreciate it.
Such a pleasure, man.
Thank you.
All right.